Welcome back to the channel, guys. Hope everybody had a good week and ready to enjoy your weekend. Anyways, we are back on the 93 mr2. As you know, we had an issue with the radiator, and I went ahead and retrofitted the factory fans to a new or used, brand new to me, radiator, aluminum radiator that I had. So I was hoping that this thing worked well. I did not film the install, but you guys saw me pull it apart, so it's the reverse. But I'm gonna give you a quick update about what we have going on here. Right now we have the radiator installed, so that's our new to me aluminum radiator. This is a fitment. I was concerned about that bleed port right there, but we did have enough clearance where we can remove that, and I had the system bled. So I actually used some hose right here. Got this at Home Depot, which fits over, so it's a half. Let's see what this is. Let me get this tag out. This is the size that I bought. So that fit perfectly well over that bleed port right here. So I was able to kind of do the same thing as what the factory requires, where you connect the bleed hose here, then you kind of attach it up here on the hood latch. And then we also went ahead and got the factory hoses connected to right here, which is where you basically bleed the heater core lines from. And you know, I kind of talked you through the process since I didn't film it, but elevated the back of the car, filled the coolant from our fill neck back here. So we went ahead, filled our coolant right here. I don't have the fancy funnels that you screw onto here with a catch, you know, like a funnel with an area that can catch the coolant as it expands. But I did have, you know, a funnel that can fit in there, doesn't screw on, but it worked well. Had a little bit of leak, you know, from the sides, but all in all, it worked pretty well. So basically filled it from here, had the back of the car elevated. And then, you know, what I did was, going back to the front of the car, I opened up the bleed screws. So this valve right here, the white top right there, just open that up and then remove this cap, open that up, connect the lines. And essentially what's gonna happen is as you fill the coolant from the back, is gonna push whatever air is in the system up through those tubes, and that's how you kind of start to purge whatever air is in the line. So that's the initial process. It really helps, you know, just from the minute you start to fill the car. So the car is off, you start to fill the coolant, that as that air is being replaced with the coolant, and it's pushing it up and through those two bleeder hoses. And then once you get everything filled to the point where, you know, your funnel in the back is filled up to the top, start the car, let it run, let it warm up. You're going to make sure you're inside the vehicle, your heater is on. So you're going to get inside here and you're going to turn on your, so basically this lever, you slide it over to heat. And this is assuming you have heater core lines attached to your car. Get the AC button in the off mode and turn that thing on full high and just let the engine run. And you know, you're gonna see the bubbles, they're gonna be coming up from the front here, and just keep running through it. Watch your temperature gauge. And what I like to do is I like to, you know, as the engine is running, I kind of get back here and I just squeeze on this radiator tube, and you're gonna see the bubbles are gonna just kind of pop right out. So yeah, I've heard some horror stories about folks trying to get this thing bled. To be honest with you, I'm kind of surprised. It seems to have worked really, really well in all the cases I've done it with these MR2s, where it doesn't take me too much time. Car doesn't overheat, runs fine. So I guess I just got lucky. But I feel like this is probably bled. I did run the engine, started running like 3 times, tried to burp the system. So now all we gotta do is get it on the ground and take it for a drive and test it out. Now, in the process of getting all of this done, I figured I would, let me go back here, figured I'd go ahead and just kind of get my clutch fluid bled. So I did that as well. And again, didn't film it, but just quick update. You open that cap, make sure it's properly filled. And then I took this wheel off, and I'm gonna try to show you guys. Heading under the car here. So we get under here. And there is, right there, that right where the light is pointed at. That's where your bleed valve is. So you just put a hose. I use a vacuum pump to just kind of pull the fluid out of the system. And it's very easy. You just basically put the vacuum pump, apply some vacuum, and then you break the bleed screw. You're gonna see fluid flowing out, and it just, as it flows out, whatever you're replacing, you just fill it in the front, and then that's how you get your clutch bled. So that's what I did, and I figured it's just, since I have the car up on jack stands, I'll just go ahead and have that clutch fluid bled, because I'm telling you, putting these cars up on a jack stand, I mean, this is probably an easier car to get on a jack stand because it's fairly light, and it's a small car, so it fits in the garage really well. But you still gotta, you know, it's a lot of on the floor backup setting the stand, so it's a process, so it's not the most fun thing to do. So I felt like that was the best way to go. But here we have it. New aluminum radiator in. I did paint my condenser here, so it kind of looks new. And the brackets were painted to match the radiator, so it kind of looks good. I like it. Now the fans are in the back, as you can see. That's them installed from the top. Looks pretty OEM. We're gonna head under the bottom. But I also did paint the AC condenser here, so I put some black. Don't know how well that's gonna show on camera, but before it was like all white and corroded. So this makes it look a little bit better. You know, I'm a little bit pleased with that. So, you know, little by little, as I always say, get these cars coming back to life. Let's head underneath, I'll show you what it looks like. All right, so we are underneath the car, and if you're gonna head underneath your car, I strongly recommend you do so with jack stands. Do not try to head under your car with just the jack alone, because safety first, so, you know. We all are guilty of trying to make shortcuts, and it's just not a good thing. So there are the fans. Let's see if I can get a good angle. So there are the factory fans installed, and again, painted, so it looks good. They all work properly. And let's see, hopefully you guys can see that. So it looks pretty decent. Looks OEM. So I'm happy I went with this route rather than using the little plastic fans that came with the system, and they're cooling fine. Based on how we run the car, they come on, keeps the temperatures down. Haven't driven it yet, but just idling in the garage and running for like 20 minutes, it works fine. Let me show you the hoses. All right, the radiator hoses were replaced as well. So those are new ones. And those are fun, let me tell you. I basically slid it onto the section closer to the front, pushed it all the way in, and then slid it onto the radiator itself. You know, it took some time, but you know, the first time you do these things, it's harder than, you know, the second time you get at it. So if I had to do it again, I would say it's not a bad job. You just need to experience doing it the first time. So just start off, guys. You will find a way and you'll get it figured out. So under here is buttoned up. I'll just show you this part as we're done. So we have the bleed port at the bottom here, and then we have that sensor that we moved over. That started to leak when I first installed it, but I needed some thread locker, so I put that on, and then everything worked well. There you go, fans are installed. And with that said, that is my update on the 93 MR2. We're gonna take this down, put it on the floor. Actually, I have to get these covers, so I have to install the under carriage covers. So these guys, we have to take these off to access the radiator, so I gotta go get these installed. I'll do that right now. And then we gotta finish putting the plastic back in here, the strut tower bar. So we'll get that done. But what I wanna do is I wanna get the plastics on first, drive this thing, then we'll come back and we'll get this outfitted. In the meantime, I have to work on the 2GR. So we have a 2GR here. And since we're on cooling, it's time to get this water neck off so we can send it out to TCS to have it modified with a filler neck. So let's get this removed and have it boxed up and on its way to Ty at TCS Motorsports. All right, on the T2GR. So to get this water neck off, there are six mounting points. So we have a nut right here, nut right here, and a bolt under here. So that's one portion of it. And then we have another portion, one, two, and three. Okay, hopefully you guys can see that. Here's some better lighting, there you go. So we're gonna pull those six mounting points. And then we have this bracket, which is from the wire harness. So we'll get that off as well. And then I know there's an O-ring in this metal pipe right here. So once we pull it, it should just slip right out. And then we're gonna remove the sensor and everything before we send it off to TCS. And I do believe that sensor is gonna be changed to, I believe, a three wire. That's a two wire right now. And that makes sure you can run your gauges, etc. inside the car. But yeah, let's just get this up. All the bolts and the nuts are out of this thing, so we got the six of them out, so it should be just to break it free. There you go. And I'm gonna go ahead and take the sensor out, and I'm probably gonna have to put the camera down just to get both hands to kind of pop this out of the O-ring that's sealing it on the pipe. But here's our sensor. We got a little copper washer here, so I gotta remember to put one of those on or replace whatever sensor we put in. But let me put some muscle into this, break it off, and I'll show you what it looks like. I let it move in magic, and we got it pulled off, and it's just gonna come this easy off. You gotta work it a little bit. I actually had to put some penetrating fluid right inside of here to slip it off of this O-ring. But you know, you put a little muscle, it comes right off. So we have those two gaskets, and then we have the O-ring, so those will have to be replaced, and we put this thing back on after it's modified. So now we're gonna see, I got my little box here, let's see if this fits. So the whole process, guys, you gotta take it off, you gotta fit it. We're filming everything. There you go, fits perfectly. So let's box this up and have this shipped out to Mr. Ty at TCS. All right, 2GR, as you can see, I'm still working away with the wire brush, and you know, knocking down the surface, it's looking much better. If you guys remember when you watched the first video, it was really corroded, a lot of oxidation. So I'm getting it off, and then I think I'm gonna paint this thing, because actually there you go, that's all that oxidation, and even that had some wire brush work done. But yeah, we gotta get this thing looking much better than it is right now. There it is, awful oxidation. We're gonna continue to work on this and then throw some paint, and it's gonna look as good or even better than the Gen 4 3S GTE that we got over there. But yeah, guys, this is a quick update, nothing too much, didn't have much going on. I wanted to put a video out, so I'm gonna get these covers on. You guys don't need to see that, there's a couple bolts under the bottom, and I will check in with you, catch you on the next one. Enjoy your day.